because you are in some trouble. They say, no, you are not credit worthy. Your last installment was late, you rejected. That's the kind of banking system we have. While people are trying to push credit cards for targets. So people who have, they get more. People who don't have, they lose more. And the have are few. The don't have are many. Correct. Okay, so this is the thing. Let me ask you this. I didn't want to get into a personal level. Do we need, the question is, don't we have enough problems? Don't we have enough problems? I told you about several major issues at a society level that we are facing. Don't we have enough? Do we go and look for more problems? Is that what we are doing? Do we look for more problems? Are you going and looking for problems? You're worrying about the past. You're overthinking about the present. You're increasing your stress level. You're unhappy. You come in a beautiful state of mind, but you want to go to a despair state. And already we have these problems. And we are all contributing to these problems. Don't think you're not part of it. Okay. So when the society itself generally is going through so many problems, okay, which means we are not alone. No, I told you, challenges don't discriminate. Problems don't discriminate. Everybody has problems. Idhila mela balengi thau problems hoyagine yanne. My question. Okay. And the biggest thing we have is anybody mentally challenged here, physically challenged here? We are blessed with a good body, a good sound mind, right? We might have problems, those are external to us, but we have strength in our hands, we have strength in our mind. Okay, so do we go looking for more problems, or isn't what we should do is being problem solvers? Shouldn't we solve problems? Shouldn't we be a small part of solving problems? All these problems I showed to you. If you teach your students about being sustainable in a small age, why do you have discipline when you go to the toilet? Because your parents potty trained you. Your parents trained you. Your parents trained you to brush your teeth in the morning. That's why you do it. That's the same thing you have to do with your kids. If they don't, when they are small, you have that power. If they don't use plastic, if they avoid plastic as much as they can, if they learn at this age when they go to the supermarket to refuse that extra polythene bag those people give, they give polythene bags for everything, no? And you go and buy goods for 5,000 bucks, you'll get about 7 polythene bags. It's crazy. And it's damaging. It's devastating. If you train your kids to refuse that bag, refuse that extra bag for now, they'll learn someday to not take one bag at all, any of the bags. So you are in a position to become problem solvers.